MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram COVID-19 update. Today we're going to talk about some of the preliminary data about the Omicron variant of SARS-CoV-2. In this chart detailing the daily new cases in South Africa, you can see here a very precipitous but small increase in the number of daily cases. Are we catching everything? Let's take a look at some preliminary data. And for this, we turn to the Daily Maverick, which is a leading South African newspaper, which published the results of wastewater surveillance data from South Africa, and specifically the Gauteng province. The Gauteng province is one of the most populated, and it is the home of one of the capital cities of Pretoria, and also one of the largest cities of Johannesburg. So the way that this is done is they look at a specific city population, and they look and test the water of the wastewater that is coming out of the city. And they sample a specific amount every time, and they treat it the same each time. And why that is important is because as people in the city become infected with SARS-CoV-2, the viral particles will be shed into the sewer water. So what's happening here is as more and more people in the city become infected with SARS-CoV-2, you'll see these viral particles start to increase in their respective patients. And of course, this nucleic acid in the middle of this viral particle is the RNA, which of course is very specific for SARS-CoV-2. Well, of course, as people become infected and these viral particles are dumped into the wastewater, they break down, and what we can find in the wastewater are those nucleic acids or the RNA. The point being, as there are more and more people that are infected with SARS-CoV-2, we'll see a linear increase in the amount of nucleic acids. What we then do is we do something called PCR, which amplifies in a very specific and standard way these nucleic acids. And so we can actually graph that out. And so what happens is when we see an increase in the nucleic acids or the RNA in the wastewater, that corresponds with an increase of infections in human beings that are in that city. So this is a nice way of detecting increases in infections that you may not be able to detect because you're not able to test everybody. And you're still able to get that information even though you're not testing every single person in the city. And that could be very valuable to pick up very early on cases of SARS-CoV-2, and specifically in increases in surges in SARS-CoV-2 in specific cities where you can have access to wastewater. So here are results from the Gauteng province in South Shwane City. You can see here that there are changes in the SARS-CoV-2 viral load. The data points and colored lines, these are these things here, in inflowing untreated wastewater from plants in the city of Shwane, compared with these bar graphs, which are laboratory confirmed cases of residents in the city of Shwane, which are the gray bars, by epidemiological week here in 2021. And you can see that these bars, which are confirmed COVID cases, are associated and seem to correlate well with the wastewater data. These brown data points represent the wastewater data in Daspoort, which is a locale in Pretoria. And you can see here, as we go on, things were going down until just a few weeks ago, about 4 or 5 weeks ago, when there was a sudden takeoff in terms of the amount of positivity in the untreated wastewater. But we're not seeing a huge increase in the number of actual confirmed cases, not as yet at least. And one may ask, why would the data points of the wastewater nucleic acids be going up when the official cases are not going up? Several explanations for this, at least two of which could be that this is happening in a population that doesn't have good access to testing. It could also be that this could be related to very asymptomatic disease, where the patients or the subjects don't know that they're infected and could be shedding viral particles in the wastewater and therefore be picking those up as nucleic acids, whereas because they're not symptomatic, they're not getting tested. I think at this point, it's just mere speculation, and we'll need more data to figure that out exactly. We're also seeing this here in Shwane North. You can see here as well, in some parts of the precinct here, the number of cases seemingly going up. Again, this is derived from wastewater. We're seeing the amplification of these RNA fragments or RNA remnants going up, where we're only seeing a slight increase in the number of cases. So an important question at this point is, can we tell exactly what type of SARS-CoV-2 variant is in the wastewater? And the answer to that is no. We can only tell if it is SARS-CoV-2. We can't tell which variant it is. So, of course, this increase in the wastewater SARS-CoV-2 nucleic acid could all be Delta or it could be any other variant. We can't tell that this is an increase in just Omicron. And so here on the World Health Organization's website, they do talk about the transmissibility. And they do acknowledge that the number of people testing positive has risen in areas of South Africa affected by the Omicron variant. However, more epidemiological studies are underway to understand if it is because of Omicron or because of other variants. So it's possible that those uptick in cases could be from something else, or it could be that the Omicron variant has found a pocket of susceptible people that have either not been vaccinated or have not had previously been infected. The concern, of course, is that Omicron may be infecting people that have been infected before with SARS-CoV-2, but because Omicron is so different than previous infections, the immunity post-infectious that was built up by these subjects is not adequate enough to protect them against this new variant. That we still don't have hard evidence for as yet, but they are working on that. There has also been some reports that hospitalizations are up. That is true. It's unclear as to whether or not those hospitalizations are increased simply because of the Omicron variant, or whether or not it is affecting the young predominantly or the very old. There have been reports of that as well. However, the WHO website says it's not clear as yet whether infection with the Omicron variant causes more severe disease compared to other infections or other variants, including Delta. Preliminary data suggests that there are increasing rates of hospitalization in South Africa, but this may be due to increasing overall numbers of people becoming infected rather than a specific infection with Omicron. Despite the fact that there have been some reports of physicians saying that the symptoms from Omicron are more mild and asymptomatic, they say here that there is currently no information to suggest that symptoms associated with Omicron are different from those from other variants. They go on to say that initial reported infections were among university students, younger individuals who tend to have more mild disease, but understanding the level of severity of the Omicron variant will take days to several weeks. Dr. Michael Minna, former Harvard professor in the School of Public Health, who we've had on a number of times here on MedCram to talk about antigen testing, said this on his Twitter feed. Rapid antigen tests detect Omicron. The bulk of mutations in Omicron, i.e. on the spike, are not near the sites that most rapid antigen tests pick up. And we will put a link in the description below to the same paper that Dr. Michael Minna also links to in his tweet that describes the process at Abbott Pharmaceuticals, which is just one of many manufacturers that are making these rapid antigen tests. This one being the Binax Now COVID-19 antigen self-test with results available within 15 minutes over the counter without a prescription. And as more information comes out, MedCram will be following that data and will be presenting further videos as that information becomes available. Don't forget to join us at MedCram.com for hundreds of videos on medical topics like ECG. Thanks for joining us.